Williams Tavern. Today we're going to be talking about chicken pot pie made in a cast iron skillet. First, we're going to go ahead and season our chicken. We're using thighs. Dark meat is a little moister and has a little bit more flavor. But if you want to be healthy, go right ahead and use some chicken breast if you want. In either case, you want to go ahead and season them liberally with some salt and pepper. Nothing fancy. You can always experiment, but this is pretty easy. And then just let those thighs kind of sit in those spices for a good bit. That'll help drive out the chicken so you can get a good caramelization and also have that the flavor of those spices penetrate deeper into the meat. Then we're going to go ahead and move towards making the dough for our crust. We have 2 cups of whole wheat flour, 2 tablespoons of brown sugar, and 1 tablespoon of salt. We're going to go ahead and just incorporate all these ingredients together. The whole wheat flour and the brown sugar is going to make for a heartier crust than using just all-purpose and white sugar. But of course, you're more than welcome to use those instead. Then we're going to go ahead and incorporate 2 sticks of cubed butter. Mix that up, making sure all the butter is covered with the flour. Once you've done that, I'm just going to dump that out on the table and start working it together a little bit. Not too much because you don't want the butter to heat up. And then you're going to move to using a rolling pin. You're just going to roll it out until the butter starts making large flakes or strips like we see here. Just kind of reforming it and continuing to roll out. And once you get something that looks like this, go ahead and add your water. About 1/2 cup should be plenty. You want to add it a little bit at a time so you don't have too much. I added a little too much here, and so once I work it together a little bit, I'm going to go ahead and flour my table and just work that extra flour into my dough ball until it's more of a consistency I like. Then I'm just going to go ahead and wrap it up in saran wrap and let it rest in the refrigerator for a while. Once that's done, I'm going to go ahead and start chopping up our vegetables. We got some celery, just run a knife through the middle of it and give it a quick chop. Take our garlic, just smash the garlic with the flat of the blade, de-peel it, give it a rough chop. Again, nothing fancy. Slice up some mushrooms. And dice up some carrots. You can use frozen varieties of all these things if you wish. And we're gonna quarter and then slice up some new potatoes. Dice up some onions, white or yellow onions, either work fine. Just stay away from something sharp like a red onion. Then we're going to drop a knob of butter into our hot skillet, let that melt a little bit, and add a little bit of pork belly. We're going to go ahead and use this pork belly later on. But the main reason why we have there, and that pork fat is basically going to be used as our cooking oil for everything else. Once we've taken out that pork belly, we're going to go ahead and add our chicken thighs. 3 thighs is really all that you need, but my package of meat had 4 of them, so I'm going to use all 4. We're going to go ahead and take those thighs out for now. Let them cool off a little bit so we can handle them later. Meanwhile, we're going to go ahead and start our vegetables. First, we're going to start off with our potato and carrots. They take a little longer to cook. And just give them a good toss. You can see all the little bits of flavor from the pork belly and the chicken thighs and brown butter collecting on it. It's delicious. And we're going to add our onions, next our mushrooms, our celery, and garlic. Keep on stirring as we go along. And then as a last minute audible, I've decided I'm gonna throw in some snow peas. While that's working, we're gonna go ahead and cut up our pork belly. Just a rough chop on it, fairly fine. And then the same also with our chicken thighs. Once that's all chopped up, we're gonna go ahead and put that in the pan and again, stir it in. Add a little bit of all-purpose flour, about 3 to 4 tablespoons should be fine. Gonna add in some chicken stock, a little bit of heavy cream, give that a good stir in. And that just looks creamy and delicious. And we're gonna go ahead and roll out our dough into a pie crust, carefully put it on to the pan, and seal it up. Go ahead and trim off the excess dough. Very important, put a couple slits in it. That's going to allow it to vent so it does not bubble out the sides too much. Give it a good wash with some beaten egg and then put in the oven at 350 degrees for about 25-30 minutes or until it looks done. And then when you pull it out, you want to let it sit for about 10 minutes. It's been working hard all day. Give it a break. And then when you're ready, just go ahead and scoop yourself out some. Crust is nice and flaky yet hearty. All those vegetables and that gravy just spilling out of it. As you can see, it's still piping hot even after it's been sitting for 10 minutes. That's the stuff. I hope you enjoyed it. Here's a sneak peek at next Friday's video, my take on French onion soup. Please hit subscribe so you don't miss out.